Hello everybody, my name is Walter and today I want to show you how you can use and customize a rather simple data pack I created that allows you to save your current position and then later on load it without having to write down the actual coordinates. Anyway, this tutorial will have three parts. In the first part I will show you how you can use this data pack. Then I will show you how this data pack works with the commands that are used. And then finally I will show you how you can customize this so you can, for example, have custom names for your save points or some other customizations. Okay, so let's start with how you can use this data pack. Well, the first step is of course downloading the data pack, the link for which can be found in the description of this video. Then you have to either copy the zip file you just downloaded into the Word folder where you want to use it, or you can unzip it in there if you want to customize this later on. And then the final step is of course the customization, which is of course optional somewhat. And I will go more into detail in the third part of this tutorial. Anyway, once you have at least the zip file or the data pack in your folder, it's time to use it. And the usage of this is rather simple. All you need to do is enter some commands. So the first command you need is the function command. And then, as you can see here in the default version, you have 10 commands or 10 options you can use. You have the S options, which is for save, then the L options, which is load, and then four delete options. And as you can see here, you have basically three save points you can use. So save point one, just use the POS as one, enter, and then as you can see here, in this default version, you have a visible little mannequin here, which shows you where your save point is. And let's say I want to have another save point in this direction. I can just put the next save point here, and let's say I want just to have the second save point here. All I have to do is use the same command here, and then the old has been deleted. So I can have up to three save points, which are independent of each other in that way. And if I now want to go back to one of those, I simply use the load command, so the load one for example, and I'm back to the same orientation and the same position as I was before when I saved. So that's basically how you can use this, and this works the same for all three save points. Now if I want to delete one of those, of course I just use the deletion button or deletion option here and then it's just deleted. Or if I want, I can just delete all, which is also an option, as you can see there. Now with that said, there are actually two limitations I need to mention. The first is that you can't use this data pack to jump between dimensions. So if you have a save point in the nether, you can't load it from the overworld, for example. But that also means that you have independent sets of save points in the various dimensions. And the second limitation is that the various commands in the data pack only work properly on an already existing save point when the armor stand, which is the save point, is actually loaded, which means that it's either in the spawn chunks, close to a player, or the chunk it is in is actually force loaded. How you can automize the force loading when saving, I will show you later on during the customization part of this tutorial. So next up is a short explanation of how the data pack actually works. Basically, if you look into the subfolders of the data pack, you will find 10 MC functions. For each of the save points, you will find a save function, a load function, a delete function, and then finally we'll have the 10th file, which is a delete all function, which removes all of the existing save points. Anyway, let's go through this example here for the first save point. The other save points are pretty much created the same way. The only deviation is more or less this tag here, which is used in pretty much all of the commands and is the identifier for the given save point. So for the save point one, I have called this tag save position one. Anyway, the first step is actually looking for an armor stand that has the correct tag, and then it will simply delete that. So an already existing save point will be deleted. The next step is summoning in a new armor stand. The various attributes here and options I will explain in a moment. Then once you've summoned in the armor stand, it is teleported to you, and this is the important part, it also is teleported to look in the same direction as you. And then finally we have this force load command here, which is in the default version commented out. which would force load the chunk you're currently in, which would guarantee that even if you are far apart from this position, you will still be able to load this position. But as I already mentioned in the default version, this is commented out, but can be easily commented in again. Anyway, let's go to the various attributes of the armor stand. So the first is I'm giving it a few tags. One tag is, as I already mentioned before, the save position one, which is the tag that identifies this save point as the save point one and is used in the save, load and delete command. The other one, the position marker, is a tag that all of the save points, so save point one, two and three, share. And that is the tag I'm using in the delete all function to identify all of the save points and then remove all of them at the same time. Next is the custom name, which is displayed when I'm looking at the armor stand. And also the custom name visibility is set to true, which also means that I'm seeing it all the time, even if I'm not looking directly on the hitbox of the armor stand. Then the gravity is turned off, so the armor stand is not falling down. It's invulnerable, so this means there is no TNT damage to it or creeper damage or whatever. Then it is visible at the moment, which can be easily changed by putting this to one. Then marker means that there is no hitbox visible, so you can't interact with it even if you are in the creative mode, outside of commands, of course. Then there is no baseplate visible. It's a child version of the armor stand, and the arms are visible. So this is just what those things here mean. Anyway, that's basically the save function. Now the load function is a bit shorter, just two commands. So the first is it checks if it can actually find a save point with the correct tag. So save position one. If it can't find one, which is through this unless here, then it will simply tell you that there was no save position visible or no save position found. And then it will try to teleport you to the save position. So basically the same command you used earlier to put the armor stand in the same point and the same orientation as you is just flipped over, and now it teleports you to the armor stand and makes sure that you look in the same direction. And then the delete one is also first checking if there is a save point existing, and then it tries to simply remove or kill that armor stand. And that's the three basic functions for each save point. The delete one works similar again. So you have again first a check if there is at least one position marker existing. And then it will remove all position markers with the position marker tag. And then finally, if you comment it in, it would also remove all force loaded chunks from the force load list. And that's basically what is going on inside of the data pack. And with that, we come to the last part of this tutorial, which is the customization of the data pack. Basically, the customization means adding new save points or adjusting the way the save point is displayed or simply renaming them. The general idea behind that analyzing is that if you have need for more save points, you simply copy those three files here and give them a new name. For example, if you need a save point within a forest, let's call it save forest, or just an F. And then you might want to also adjust the marker names here, all the way through all of the commands. And you're more or less done. The only thing you still might want to adjust is the custom name. So basically this here is a JSON text, which is displayed when you are looking roughly in the direction of the armor stand. And it's in this case made out of two strings. The first string is a simple text with save point ending with a white space in it. And the second one is a simple one at the moment in the color red. And for this example, we just might want to write forest in there. So now you have a save point you can put in the forest and displays save point forest as a name. Now there are of course a few more things you might want to adjust concerning the armor stand itself. So the most important ones of those are the visibility of the custom name and the visibility or invisibility of the armor stand itself. So if you just change those here, for example, to no custom name visible and invisible on, that would mean that you have now a save point which is not visible inside of the world, which might be a good idea if you want to do any recording in the vicinity. Of course, you can also change the size of the entire thing, or if it shows arms, or you can even put some items inside of the hands of it, but if you want to know more about this, I would recommend looking in the corresponding wiki articles. And that was basically how you can use my save points in Datapack. I hope you enjoyed this little tutorial, and well, see ya!